Hi, and welcome back to Reflections. I'm Veronica Brown, and today's topic is Stop the Strife, Protecting Unity. So let's start off with our salvation prayer. Lord, I am a sinner. I believe that you died for my sins. I ask you to come into my life and live your life in me, and I make you my Lord and Savior. Don't forget to find a good church and be baptized in Jesus' name. So let's start off with our subject today. Stop the strife. Protecting unity. Today we recognize the importance of teamwork. There is great power when partnering with like-minded people. No, we're not the same. Our diversity is our power, our strength. On this day of the 20th anniversary of 9/11, we remember the thousands who died in the attack on New York and Washington, including the passengers and the crew of the two aircraft that served the terrorists as missiles to crash into the Twin Towers. My special thoughts go to the passengers and the crew of American Airlines Flight 77 that was deliberately crashed into the side of the Pentagon, and the United Airlines Flight 93, whose passengers and crew fought in unity, fought as one against their hijackers. They gave their lives to avoid their airplane hitting the Capitol in Washington. You may or may not know, I've been a flight attendant since 1998, and everyone, especially flight attendants, all crew, everyone working in aviation, but everyone around the United States and around the world, they remember exactly where they were, what they was doing when this occurred. I remember being in Minneapolis, getting my children ready for school that morning. I remember getting my children out the door, off to school, to get on their bus. I ran back into my bedroom to get back in my bed to enjoy my first morning of my vacation. I continued to watch the news, and all of a sudden I saw this plane go into a building. I said, you know, is this a joke? But anyway, I saw the whole thing happen. I just couldn't believe it. My phone began to ring in my bedroom. I jumped up to answer the phone. My family members began to call me to make sure I wasn't flying that day. And then the whole thing evolved. So this has been very important to me. It's been very emotional for me. So today is a special day, not just for me, but for all of us. Psalms 133, verse 1, reminds us how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. God's goal for the body of Christ is living in unity and giving one another encouragement. We must avoid words that create discord, strife, and confusion in our family and in the church, on our jobs, in our community and cities, in our government. The Apostle Paul addressed this in 2 Corinthians 12:20. He writes, the church was not behaving as it should, as the body of Christ, as our country, and as our world. Paul was concerned he would find the church full of fighting, jealousy, selfish ambition, backbiting, and gossip. Lashon Hara, which means evil tongue. This is still a concern in today's church. The enemy is trying to divide us, and a kingdom divided against itself cannot stand. Your part is to guard the body of Christ by speaking positive, faith-filled words. This positions you and others to experience salvation, healing, prosperity, and unity. As always, my friends, let's close out today's reflections with a prayer. Father, right now, I break every curse and every negative seed that I have sown. I release every blessing you intended. I put a guard on my mouth and pray that from now on, I will use my words only to build people up and not tear them down. Father, I pray and thank you that you will guard and protect and give the families that lost their loved ones on 9/11 the peace that they need, the peace that they're seeking, that passes all understanding. In the name of Yeshua the Messiah, amen. Until we meet again, my friends, to quote Minister Clarence Brown and Pastor Walter Pearson, may God hear you when you call. May God lift you when you fall. May God bless you when you stand, and may God hold you in the palm of his hands. May God bless you, yes, even you.